Wish they take all wallhack characters out. Me too. Which is sad because I'm pretty sure the next character also has a wallhack ability. Could be wrong. Definitely could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure.
What up? It's your boy NWP, and we're back at it once again with another video. And as you can tell by the intro there, we definitely got some interesting stuff to talk about it. And it definitely comes from someone that has some inside access. And maybe it hints at a different legend than yesterday's video concerning Mad Maggie, who is, by all accounts, is most likely going to be the Season 12 legend. And potentially, she has a wall hack ability. I don't know so much about that one, but I do know that one of the leaked legends that is coming relatively soon does, in fact, have a wall hack ability in their leaked kit. And while it has been changed a little bit over time, I still think that ability would be pretty amazing. But first, if you enjoy the channel, then how about taking the time right now to like this video? And if you're new, smash down that subscribe button with the notification bell so that you can get alerted anytime that I drop a new video. So let's get into this one. Obviously, ACU has a lot of access to different things Apex related. He's a huge creator with a huge following and has done some of the craziest things that we've seen in game, as well as being one of the best movement players available. Now, the thing about this is he says that he believes the next legend has a wall hack ability and that he's pretty sure, he could be wrong, but he's pretty sure that this legend has a wall hack ability. Now, for me, the wall hack ability screams Blisk and the original toolkit that he had, which was actually, you know, the passive of the throwing knife that then tracks the enemy if you kill that enemy. So basically the idea was you hit somebody with the throwing knife, and then if you kill them, their teammates will be revealed to you, similar to kind of Ashe's death box ability. Now, obviously, that could have been changed simply because, you know, Ashe has an ability very close to that. And we've seen some kind of abilities get moved around a little bit and changed a little bit because, by all accounts, when we look at Fuse, he's most likely the leaked character Firebug and has a bunch of fire-related abilities and grenade abilities. So very, very much also fits the populist pyromaniac idea, which a populist is kind of an anarchist in a sense, someone that doesn't believe in the government and kind of believes in their own whole idea. Now, there's a lot more nuance to it than just saying an anarchist, but for just, you know, a brief overview, it's kind of fits that whole vibe of Fuse, where his idea was F the man, let's get rid of the man, let's become, you know, the top of the crop ourselves, let's do this. So realistically speaking, there's definitely a lot of stuff being reworked and added into different toolkits and stuff like that when we look at the old leaked legend abilities that have been around for almost 3 years now. But when you have an insider that says that they believe the next legend has a wall hack ability, what we can infer from this directly is that there is a legend in the test roster that does have wall hack abilities. So we have another wall hack ability legend coming at some point soon. Now, I'm going to say that most likely Mad Maggie is going to be the Season 12 legend, and I don't think she's going to have a wall hack ability. But then again, if you argue the point with Fuse's ultimate, it's very much possible that she has something similar to Fuse in that regard, where if you're stuck in one of her abilities, she can see you. Kind of like if you're in the mother load, you're actually going to appear as a red highlighted target. So I could see them doing something like that, but I just don't think it fits the Maggie character, nor do I think it fits the Husaria ability kit being changed like that. So I do think that there's going to be some changes in terms of what ACU thinks is going to happen, but I definitely think he's given us a lot of information without even realizing it about what the potential future roster does look like. And when we look at the roster leaks, we can see that there is a bunch of these characters already leaked, and they clearly are really in the game and being tested. So whether you'd like to believe it's a forged situation or not, the fact is these are characters that are really in the game and have really been tested at least a little bit. Now, specifically speaking, if we zoom in and point at one direct character, that one right there, I believe, is actually Mad Maggie. Now, going by the hair and the untextured look, you can't be too sure, but going by the hairstyle, what I see is definitely very, very similar to Mad Maggie and her braided dreadlock look that she has going on. So I do think Mad Maggie is definitely in our roster list, and I do think that Blisk is definitely in the roster list, and it's definitely those two characters that are going to be the argument for who's going to be coming out in season 12. But with all the different things appearing in the game files for Mad Maggie, it does seem that Mad Maggie would be the obvious shoe-in for the spot in season 12. Plus, I don't think it's necessarily the right time directly after Ash to add in Blisk, the Apex Predator himself. So I do think we're going to see at least a stuttered out one stutter season before we see, as I stutter the whole time there. But I think we're definitely going to have that momentary delay before we get another Apex Predator, if you will, added to the game. I do think we clearly are going to see more of the surviving characters from Titanfall and the Apex Predators get added over time. But I do think, as we've heard the developers say directly, that we're not going to see them just willy-nilly add things into the game, and that we're more likely going to see them add them when they believe we need them. Now, that says a lot about weaponry, more so than a legend, because there isn't necessarily a legend ability toolkit that we need. There's ones that we'd like to use, and there's really cool, interesting stuff that could be added, but there isn't a legend type or set that we need specifically added to the game. So I think when we take into account that whole what needs to be added, we're talking about a little bit more about the story than we are the actual legend abilities. But it all remains to be seen in the next few months here as we head towards season 12. And obviously, there's a lot of information still to be found, and we know that there's still a lot of information about this season that has not yet come out. So we should be seeing some interesting stuff happening within the next few weeks. Obviously, this month we will be seeing, or not this month, but next year in the beginning of the month, we will be seeing the beginning of some teasers and other stuff like that for season 12. And obviously, with that kind of stuff happening, there's going to be a lot more information to be dug up and released to the public, as well as, you know, the potential for the inside leakers to start leaking information about the playtests that will start ramping up a little bit more in the next coming weeks. So we should be seeing a lot more information coming up soon, and we should be getting a lot more, at least valuable information from the developers rather than what we've been seeing over the last few weeks and months. Obviously, things have gotten better in Apex in terms of the overall feel of the game. Like, we definitely have a more reliable game right now. It's much more stable. Servers are a lot more stable. There's still people having issues. I'm sure there's going to be comments down there like, oh, the servers suck for me. Well, you know, on the majority part, there is people not complaining like they were last season and the season before. So there is good things as we move towards season 12 happening, and obviously they did kind of keep their promise to work on the game and make it better and try and make it more fruitful for us. Obviously, the developers are actually taking a little bit of time off for the holidays right now, as expected and well-deserved, even though not everything's perfect in the game. The fact is, these guys are busting their humps every single day, day in and day out, to bring us a game that we all love and enjoy to play. So while there is issues and bugs and stuff that I'd wish they would fix immediately, I know how coding and development actually is. It's not necessarily possible for them to do that. So, hey, whatever they can do that they put out that's amazing, I'm glad to see it. And I hope that they continue to work on Apex as a love project more than, you know, a money project where they feel as though it's the only way to sustain. But that's just me. I'd love to hear what you guys have to say about it. Drop a comment down below. Let me know what you think ACU was talking about. Is Mad Maggie going to be a recon character? Or is Blisk going to be the season 12 legend with his old school recon toolkit being added into the game? Or is it some legend we haven't talked about at all? And do you think there's going to be something unique with this legend that we've never seen before? Or will it just be a remix of another legend, kind of like Seer? Let me know in the comment section down below. And obviously, guys, if you'd like to continue this conversation, head over to the social media links. Give them a like, a favorite, a follow. It's the best way to keep in touch with me and to find out all the crazy nonsense I'm doing. Plus, if you'd like to get featured in a video sometime, it's the best way to send me gameplays and you show me stuff that you're up to in Apex Legends. So it's really, really that simple. Head on over to the social media links. Give them a like, a favorite, a follow. It's easy. And obviously, it's a cheap and effective Christmas present for all content creators. But yeah, guys, new year coming up really soon. Christmas in the bag. We had, Thanksgiving in the bag, Halloween in the bag. The holiday season is pretty much over, with the last main holiday being the new year, which in, you know, the most realist sense is not really a holiday, but it is. So we're going to celebrate anyways, and most of us will probably, if we're of legal age for consumption, we'll be getting pretty toasty and lit up that evening. But, for everybody else that can't partake, hopefully you'll have some fun listening to all the drunk streamers and YouTubers partying and acting a fool as we move into the new year, because I'm probably going to be live myself for the New Year's. Doing at least a couple hours of streaming, hanging out, having some drinks. I don't know if I'll be actually playing any games or anything in particular, but I will definitely probably go live to hang out with the Floop Troop in general, as you guys have been amazing for the last 2 years, and I just, couldn't do it without you guys. So, little online party. Maybe we can even, get some other, people to use their webcams and cam in, and we'll have a big actual digital party, some kind of nonsense like that. It'd be pretty, it could be interesting. We'll see what we can get together and make happen on the new year, and hopefully it'll be as epic as this past year. Obviously, the pandemic's still going on, and we're not necessarily back to normal where people would like to be, but if you're alive and you're breathing and you're healthy, at least you got that going for you. So can't complain myself. At least everything is going a lot better right now. But here's another video you can check out if you feel so inclined. Thanks for watching. Thanks for liking. Thanks for subscribing. And I'll continue to bring you guys news, Apex-related content, and even more in 2022. But you need to stay safe, stay healthy, and as always, have a good one.